something in the mail today. And it's going to be what I was looking forward to out here. Ooh-wee. Got some weight forward 6-line. Rass. Got some piper. And Lamson Waterworks. Real. You see this puppy. Ooh, man, look at that prettiness. Look at that prettiness. Nice. Ooh, yeah. That is nice. Alright. So, it's got a drag on here. I have one for a 6-weight, so this is the next size up. This is nice. Okay, let's see what we got here. Oh. Let's see what we got to do to get this thing off here. Okay. All right, man, it's sealed tight. That's the deal. Oh, it just pops off. Okay. So. Oh, that's the drag on it. Alright, here's the reel. And apparently. This just, breaks a seal, maybe? Okay, cool, man. This thing's like machined, excellent. So here's the, so I guess this is the drag. Oh no, that there takes that thing off. Okay. So. I guess that's the clicker. Yeah, that's the clicker on it. Some line here to put on it. Okay. So. Go get that other one. Oops, I forgot to film this, but I put the backing on here, and I went around it twice, and then I tied like an Albright knot and tied it on here. All right. Okay. And then. And it says it takes 200 yards of backing, but I'm only putting, you know, all I have is 150 on this little spool that I have. And, I can't reel this all up, but when I get all of this on there, I'll to show you how to tie the fly line. What you do to tie the strings, you kind of put a loop like this, right? And you're going to use the string. I can't remember the name of the knot, but you're going to wrap this around probably about 8 or 9 times. They make a tool for this to make it a lot easier. Yeah, you just kind of wrap it around. See, and it kind of like cinches down, so you gotta kind of be careful. So it bites down on itself and just trim off the tag ends. This is probably the sloppiest job that you've ever seen, but it works as long as it's effective. Okay. And then reel it up. I've never tried reel line. I'm normally an Elk Orvis guy, but this sucks. No welded loop. Well, so we're gonna have to get some like 20-30 pound test mono and put it on there the same way. All right, well there it is. I got this fly line free with this reel. So all right, so here's the Echo rod. It's the Badass Glass Quick Shot. Heard that this rod has very high accolades. All right, well, the rod's the, okay, we're just gonna find it. Okay, so, cellophane off. Okay, look, I heard people say that this rod had some problems with, like, the blank itself was great. But like the everything else, the hardware and the cork was junk. I have seen yet this, and there's the Badass Glass. This is the rod I'm going to be going fishing with. Okay, so you do need to kind of line it up. Okay, let's go ahead and put the reel on just to see where it goes. Oh, there it is. So when putting this on, okay, kind of hold it down like that and then tighten it up. Okay. All right. So line these holes up, right? Right here. One, two, line them up. This is just, it's, this is a sweet rod, dude. This is a nice rod. And, you know, it's not a terribly expensive rod. It may be a little on the heavy side, but I don't see it. I don't see it being any heavier. I'll do a comparison because I got a Lamson reel on my, with my other 6-weight, okay? And, oh yeah, this puppy is a sweet stick. And it's fiberglass. So it's going to be durable. It is nice. Yeah, this is nice. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get some mono on here to make me a little string loop. I'll be back. I think it's called a nail knot. That's what it's called. Okay, so double it over. Kind of just pull it tight here. That's not pretty, but it'll work. Okay. Be a little wind resistant.